Hi, this is your girl Wilma. We're going to be studying the Word of God together, and get your Bibles out because when I speak the scriptures off, you open it up and find it, okay? This is called, what my theme is today is how to know if you are truly following God's will for your life. One example, when you are following God's will for your life, you will not always choose easiest path forward. The easiest road is not always the best road. If you turn to Matthew 7, 13 and verse 14, it says, and Jesus said in Matthew 7, 13, 14, enter by the narrow gate, for the gate is wide and the way is easy that leads to destruction, and those who enter in by it are many. For this gate is narrow and the way is hard that leads to life, and those who find it are few. Number two, turn to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 1 through 3. Number two, turn to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 1 through 3. Number two, when you are following God's will for your life, you will not be perfect, but you will be progressively moving forward in maturity. When the Spirit of God comes to dwell within the Christians, He does not possess you and take over you like a demon possesses a person, no. Rather, though, through the Spirit, we are given the power to choose to obey God's will for our lives. This progress of learning to submit to the Spirit truly in a process for turn to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 1 through 3. Finally, then, brothers, we ask and urge you in the Lord Jesus that as you receive from us how you ought to walk and to please God, just as you are doing, that you do so more and more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus, for this is the will of God, your sanctification. That's the will of God. All right, number three. Now you can turn to Timothy, second chapter, verse 24 through 16. I said that wrong. All right. Third, number three. When you are following God's will for your life, you will start to think differently than the world around you. You will. Most of the world is not following God's will. You will be able to see this not only by how they disobeyed the commands of God, but also by the clash of ideas the Christian mind has with those who are not Christians. Paul warned Timothy about this when he said, and the Lord's servants must not be quarrelsome. And he didn't like anybody quarrels with someone or makes a fuss or even starts one. All right. But kind to everyone, able to teach, patiently enduring evil, correcting his opponents with gentleness. God may perhaps grant them repentance, leading to a knowledge of the truth, and they may come to their senses and escape from the snare of the devil after being captured by him to do his will. Number four. All right, we're still on number three. And turn to Romans chapter 12, verse 2. As it states, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is the good and acceptable, perfect. All right, now we're on number four. You can turn to Galatians chapter 5, verse 17. Galatians chapter 5, verse 17. Okay. Number 4. When you are following God's will for your life, you will be intentionally making it your goal to follow Him. You got to make it a goal. Your goal in life. You will not follow God's will by accident. Everything in us wants to naturally go the opposite way. Our old nature rebels against the Spirit leading. Therefore, when we just turn on our autopilot mode and start living in an unintentional way, we will always veer from God's will for our life, as said in Galatians chapter 5, verse 17. Explains, for the flesh desires what is contrary to the Spirit. And that's what the flesh does. And the Spirit, what is contrary to the flesh. They are in conflict with each other, so that you are not to do whatever you want. Not going to get to do whatever you want. That flesh, you know, it always gets in the way. Okay, you can turn to Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 and 10. So, one prerequisite to following God's will for your life is an internal intensiveness to staying aware of God's will for your life. Notice how Jesus intentionally taught us to pray that we would stay focused on following God's will. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth that is in heaven. You can keep on reading that if you want. All right, you can turn to Ephesians chapter 5, verse 15 through 17. Ephesians. It says, as Paul said in Ephesians, look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise, making the best use of the time, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. He wants us to be wise, don't he? Number 5. When you are following God's will for your life, the promises on the pages of the scriptures will start manifesting in your life. Yes. When God says something, it always happens. Therefore, whenever the Bible promises a certain result for a certain action, you will always see those results when you take those biblical actions. All right. Make sure you're living for the Lord completely. Because we'll not get the promises, right? Therefore, when you are truly following God's will, you turn to John chapter 7, verse 17. When you're truly following God's will for your life, the promises of Scripture will manifest in your life. For the Jesus said in John 7 and 17, anyone who chooses to do the will of God will find out whether they by teaching comes from God or whether I speak on my own. You'll know them. You'll know the Spirit. So many times we block out our blessings from coming by not being obedient to God, God's Word. And if we just take the time to listen for His will and then be doers of it, we would be walking in the way of victories. And then we are. Commit and say, I will seek God's wisdom today, for I know that it's only by His wisdom for my life that I will be successful. Lord, open my heart and my ears to hear from you today. Speak, for I am listening. Now that's if you know that you are living for the Lord wholeheartedly and so, okay? So, has that been said? I hope you enjoyed our scripture reading today and our studies that we have done today. And I hope I have opened the scriptures up for you to understanding it. And I hope you followed me on it, because that was some good teaching today. And thank you for stopping by my channel. And I hope I meet you again next time on our next video.